Butch and Bob Show. World famous Butch and Bob Show here on WIFO 105.5 FM in Jessup, Big Dog Country Radio. Good morning, Bob.
Good
morning. Doing well?
Doing well.
Doing well. Enjoying that cool temperature outside? No, I am.
Feels pretty good.
Feels pretty good. Loving it. Well, so we got
to be down in the 30s over the weekend.
Right? Yeah, 37 tomorrow night, 37 Saturday night.
I'm not looking forward to that.
You're not looking forward to that? Oh, Bob, it's not that bad.
I don't like cold weather.
Still above freezing.
That's all right. I'm not a cold weather kind of person, but it's okay.
All right. Well, we've got the two sets of guests this morning. One here in the studio, one in the green room. Who do we have here in the studio with us this morning, Bob?
Today, we'll start with the varsity volleyball coach and varsity girls basketball coach, Kayla Hobbs, in. Kayla, always good to see you. Appreciate you coming in.
Good to see you, too. Thank you for having me.
Basketball season's about to wrap up, but first I want to go back to volleyball. The volleyball team recently had their banquet, and they had a good season. Again, ran into a buzzsaw in the state playoffs with the team that had, like, four Division One volleyball
yeah,
players.
Yeah, they were unbelievable.
6 foot seven, six whatever.
They really were great.
Yeah.
6 foot seven girls?
Yeah.
It did, yeah. Played wow. Marist. They were, had a sophomore, that was nationally ranked.
Yeah, that private high school in Marist, yeah.
Yeah.
They're kind of like the BC of Atlanta.
They were unbelievable.
But anyway, so you had the banquet. Go run down some of the awards that were handed out.
Yeah, we had a great banquet this season. I'll go through some of my JV awards. We had our leading server this season was Jaden Thompson. Jaden actually started some for us in our varsity toward the end of the season, just a really good all-around player. Bella Brown, she was our most improved player. Kinsley Mount, she played at our net. She also had some valuable varsity minutes. She was our leading hitter. We had Kaslyn Taylor, she was our hustle award. And Kinsley Branch got our yellow jacket award. Marina Howard, she had the highest number of blocks for the season for our JV this year. And our defensive player of the year was Carly May. And our varsity awards, our impact player of the year was Mimi Everett. Our highest serve percentage was Macy McDuffie. Our leading ace server was Kennedy Mercer. Our setter of the year was Bailey Spradley. Offensive player of the year was Alyssa Robinson. Her and Mimi both, they played middle at our net and were really huge for us this season. Hustle award went to Ireland Rivero. Our utility player of the year was Addie Mullis. Our defensive player of the year was Addie O'Neill. And our MVP this season was Gracie Velosin.
Yeah, I'm always curious. Like I said, you know, basketball players, you can go outside and play basketball, football, you know. Where are these volleyball girls? Where do they get the, is there somewhere they get together and practice and have a good time? Or
it's
or,
really tough, yeah.
I mean,
so a lot
have,
of them.
Do they have to have a gymnasium to do that?
For it to be, you know, true work, yeah, a gym is ideal, and we do struggle with that here in Wayne. Just because, you know, I know we're in the process of potentially getting a rec gym here soon, but right now with there being no rec and not really being like a general facility gym, it is a struggle for them. Most of them, their parents have put them up nets in the backyard. They do have balls, and they do have a lot of drills. They do, you know, like into a wall or do at home. But it is hard just because it's really hard to go back and forth on a net and actually play like you would be able to play like an outdoor basketball game. But a lot of, you know, their parents are trying. They get them set up and get them nets and all. And some of them, you know, they'll all go to somebody's house, especially right before we start the season, and work together and just try to do what they can on their own.
Well, what do they do with the gym there next to James E. Bacon, next to the old high school? What's that being used for?
I think that is where the wrestling team is now.
Wrestling team is where they
yes.
do their practices and
right.
everything. Okay.
And, of course, you're the girls' varsity basketball. You've had a scrimmage game and a regular season game. So tell us how the basketball team is going and when – I think you have a holiday tournament you're coming up on.
Yeah, we turn around. We scrimmaged Jeff Davis. I think we lost by four to them. We lost by one to Long County. We did have some players missing from those games. And we'll turn around and we'll play Saturday and Monday. So Saturday we'll play Coffee, and Coffee's pretty good. And then we'll play Dodge. And Dodge is – we haven't played them in the last 2 years. But before we played – before these last 2 years, probably our previous – six or seven, they were pretty big rivals, and so we will play them on Monday, and then we will go to Brunswick High on Tuesday, and we'll come back the next week and we'll play an away game at Long, and then we'll play our first home game against Brantley County on Thursday, December 5th.
December 5th. So, you know, everybody knows about the unfortunate. Are you still without some? How long do they have to sit out?
So they will.
When you get your full squad back.
They sat out the scrimmage, and that was part of our, you know, just our team discipline action. And then the state had the first two, so that was Long County. And then the Coffee game, they will also sit out, and we will have our full varsity returning to us Monday for the Dodge game.
Okay. What were some of the starters this year for the basketball team? Let's give them some airtime.
So we don't necessarily have starters yet because we haven't brought back our entire varsity.
But when they do come back,
I'll tell you that you know, we didn't lose any seniors last year, so we returned our entire team.
Great.
So last year's starters were Taylan Ward, Jakelia Fulmore, Mimi Everett, Sunny Deshaw, and Kalasia Colbreth. And I look for all of those to be returning and at least, you know, fighting for those positions back as we get started. Other seniors, Alyssa Tillman, she returns as our sixth man. Najah Davis got hurt early in the season. She was doing really well for us and getting a lot of minutes before she had a knee injury. Which is kind of a mix of, we have a good group of seniors and good group of sophomores and some juniors sprinkled along the way. Destiny Rooks is a junior, and Alyssa Robinson is also a junior. They both have been with me since their freshman year on the varsity.
Okay.
So we do have some players that have experience, and you know, I really hope that that will help us as we get into our region. Our region's going to be pretty tough, and I think we're going to need it when we see some of those opponents like Warner Robbins and Ware.
All right. We know Ware's pretty good. Warner Robbins, how about New Hampstead? I know New Hampstead didn't field a girls softball team because they didn't, but what about basketball?
So I didn't know they didn't field their softball team. Their basketball team is also usually very low in numbers. They've traditionally been, it's kind of been scrappy. Like we've played them close. They actually last year, the game to get into the region championship, they went into overtime with Burke. So they're a scrappy group, kind of hard to say because they do have some moving in and out things going on. They always have new players, and then they always lose good players too. It's kind of weird. So I do know they had one player I saw on Twitter last night that scored 42 points against Hilton Head, or one of the private schools over in Hilton Head. And I can't really verify if that was, you know, very competitive or not. So do they have one good player? I don't expect them to have a full 10. So it sounds probably pretty similar to how the softball situation is.
All right. Again, just joining us, Kayla Hobbs, volleyball coach and girls varsity basketball coach. What about Perry High School? What kind of, I mean, they normally have pretty good programs.
Yeah.
You don't have to play, worry about BC because they don't have the girls.
Right, yes, so. Thankfully. yeah, Perry's pretty decent too. It will be a tough region for us. Warner Robbins and Ware both are, you know, they're both going to be really good teams. I don't really think there's going to be one team that I can say that we can, you know, beat for sure, but I think it's going to be one of those things where if we don't come out to play, you know, we could lose to any of them. And if we do, if all, you know, all girls on the court for me come out and really do what, you know, they're capable of doing and do their potential, you know, you could beat them all too. So it'll be interesting, and I think it's going to be one of those things that come down to the tournament.
Well, again, we wish the best of luck. Again, the holiday tournament, but the first game again, December the 5th, is that correct?
December the 5th will be at home against Brantley.
And that's a Friday or a Thursday?
It's a Thursday. We'd moved it in the event of football, but that's usually a pretty big game for us. Brantley is, you know, a very aggressive and scrappy group, and they're well coached, and they do a good job of their program too. And so that's usually a pretty good game to watch if you're looking to come support the girls. Thursday would be a big one to come to.
Okay. Again, we wish you best of luck. Appreciate you coming in. How many years have you been with Wayne County now?
This is my 11th year.
11th season.
Yep.
So, and the volleyball team continues to get better and better. So
yep. Volleyball's growing.
Yeah. How long we've had volleyball now? What year was
eight.
This?
I think this is eighth
year.
Eight. Yep. And we're actually looking to – we're trying to figure out a way now to try to figure out a way to start a travel squad because the nearest squads, you know, around here for travel for volleyball is – Jacksonville, and every once in a while Brunswick will have one, and so, you know, my girls are looking for ways to keep playing and getting better, and so we're looking to start that now, So I'll keep you posted on that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, Coach, again, appreciate you coming in. Wish you the best of luck. Look forward to the basketball season. And soon you'll have your full squad back. Yep. That'll be good. So best of luck.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. Thank you, Coach. WIFO-FM in Jessup. We've got more guests coming on in just a moment here on the World Famous Butch and Bob Show here on WIFO.
Here's your WIFO forecast.
Good morning, everyone. We're looking forward to sunshine today. Off to a chilly start this morning. It's going to stay breezy through the afternoon. Highs will be in the mid-60s. Tonight, clear, very cool, with lows close to 40 degrees. Tomorrow for Friday will be sunny, very breezy. Highs will be near 60. Then on Saturday, sunny, a little warmer, with highs in the mid-60s. I'm Georgia meteorologist Laura Huckabee in the GNN Weather Center.
Where can you see the wonder upon the face of a child? Adults reminded of hope and God's love for the world. At the Walk Through Living Nativity presented by Altima Hall Baptist Church, the Living Nativity will take place on Wednesday, December the 4th and Thursday, December the 5th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the JC Fairgrounds on Highway 301 North across from the mill. The Living Nativity takes you back in time to Bethlehem, the birthplace of Jesus, the Savior of the world. When you visit Bethlehem, you will discover Roman guards on horseback, women, men, and children working in the marketplace, townspeople coming to pay their taxes, live animals, and most importantly, Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus lying in a manger. This free event is for the whole family to enjoy. Please make plans to attend the Live-In Nativity Wednesday, December the 4th and Thursday, December the 5th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the JC Fairgrounds.
Big Dog Country Radio, WIFO, 105.5 FM in Jessup. We continue on with the world-famous Butch and Bob Show. We got Ken here from the Jessup VFW. How you doing, Mr. Bohannon?
I'm doing fine, sir. How are you, Butch?
Doing good.
It's good to see you guys.
All right, it's good to see you back on here. You were here a few days ago. What else is going on with the Jessup VFW?
All right. Well, coming up this Saturday, we have our golf tournament, our 21st annual golf tournament. Starting this Saturday morning, I think tee off time, shotgun start is at 8:30. We're going to be giving away some prizes and stuff like that for all the golfers out there this morning. Put on your turtlenecks and long sleeves. It might be have a little bite that morning, but things are still moving forward. There's going to be food provided for the golfers there on site. The auxiliary has done an amazing job putting this together. Susan Simmons, she's kind of been heading this up for years now. So it's her 21st Memorial Golf Tournament.
21st?
Yep. Wow. 21 years, you believe that.
Yeah. Wow. Time flies, doesn't it, Ken?
Yes, Lord, it does.
And so this is coming up this weekend, you said?
Yeah.
This weekend, you still got spots available?
Yeah, there's plenty of spots.
So it's a four-man scramble. There will be two flights. It's $80 per player, prizes based on minimum of 20 teams. And so what better way to go out and have a beautiful Saturday, going to be sunny, and help out the veterans and have fun playing golf. So if folks want to put the team together and be there in the tournament, how do they do that, Ken?
Number one, you can just show up at Pine Forest out there that morning. The auxiliary will be out there around 7:30 preparing everything. Registration, if you want to show up and have your team together, I think around 8 o'clock. Miss Susan Simmons, like I said, she's heading that up. And if you have any questions about that, you can reach out to her at 912-223-4429. She's like, you know, doing this thing and been doing it. So
Susan does a great job with that. And she's, you know, very involved in the auxiliary and does a great job with helping out the VFW. And so, folks, have some fun this Saturday in the 21st annual Leon Parish VFW Annual Golf Tournament. Four-man scramble, two flights, just $80 per player for all the fun. And they're going to be complimentary food and drinks, barbecue meal, after the tournament, and all kinds of fun. And of course, the main thing, of course, is helping out the veterans and the things that y'all do at the VFW to help the veterans.
Yeah, we cannot do it without our community, and you guys out there appreciate our whole community. We had a car show this past weekend, and we had like 29 cars, and showed up in force, man. We cannot thank our car enthusiasts for coming out to support our little benefits we have to try to help our vets in our community and stuff. So I want to give a shout-out to all the car guy gurus and trucks. And
so that went real well this past Saturday?
Oh, man, we had a blast. They even put the commander in the Duncan booth, so there you go.
Yeah, so you got in the Duncan booth, huh?
Yeah, it was cold. It was cold, brother.
Did he have some good pitchers there that hit right on the mark and dunked you in?
They got some live-action photos, and I don't know where they went, say the commander, but, they got some good pitchers, had another member jump up there and did his thing with me, and it was cold. The water was cold.
Well, at least it's not going to be this Saturday.
Yeah, you're right, because we might have to take a rain check on that. Yeah.
We're going to take an ice check this
Saturday. Oh, they want to do that, too. They want to do the commander do a polar plunge, but, I don't know about all that.
Yeah, who used to have the polar plunge around here? Was it the Rotary Club, Bob? Or who was it that used to have the Rotary Club give them somebody's polar plunge in their backyard, like in January or something like that, to raise funds or something like that?
Thumbs up for them. You're not splashing a dunk tank last weekend. It gave me a new perspective on water.
Yeah. Now, you see these people, like in the Northeast or in Alaska, places like that, in January or something like that, they go out and have a polar plunge. These people got to be nuts. I mean, the water out there is just above freezing,
Crazy. I mean, they were raised.
And you
in
run
that
out
kind
there,
and
you run back, and somebody throws a towel around you and stuff like that. But
I was born and raised in South Georgia, so
yeah. Here's your $20. I'm not going in. Here's the money for the
right.
Yeah. Here, I'm going to donate $20. I'm not going in that water.
We will not be doing the backstroke today. Yeah, it turned out real good, and we had a lot of fun, and thanks to our community to help us with that. And again, we can't do nothing without your listening area and the community to join in to help us, and my hat's off for them, because the community stepped up, and it was a great day.
Well, y'all had a good car bike and truck show. That was fantastic.
Yeah, we did good. We really did good. It was good to see a lot of people and, meet some that I've already know, and we just had a blessed day.
So. Okay, and once again, this is the Leon Parrish VFW 21st Annual Golf Tournament. 21 years of helping the veterans out in this area, and they're looking for more teams, four-man scramble, two flights, $80 per person. For more information, call Susan Simmons. She's involved with the auxiliary at the VFW. You can give Susan Simmons a call at 912-223-4429. 223-4429. And that's this weekend. And if they just want to show up with the team on Saturday morning, what time should they be there?
Somewhere around 8 o'clock would be fine. Like I said, the shotgun starts is at 8:30. So
8:30? Okay, shotgun shot.
Use up all my mulligans already. So
okay. All right.
I'm good.
All right. So Bob's been getting pretty good at Pine Forest. He's out there on Wednesdays and Saturdays playing regular all the time. He doesn't have to use mulligans anymore.
Really?
No more mulligans. Bob. I mean, he's past that. He's gotten that good.
Really?
Yeah.
I might need to borrow some of his then.
All right. You got something else going on with the Just at VFW. What is that, Ken?
Yeah. So now through the 14th, we're going to be doing our toy drive for our kids in our community. We got kids out there, we're gonna provide Christmas for them, and we ask them for donations. They can drop off at the VFW anytime after 3. I got contact with a big man in the red suit. He's gonna tell me to get my biker buddies together, and we're gonna bring Santa in on some motorcycles for him, for the kids that day.
Okay.
That'll be at the VFW post on Saturday the 21st.
Okay.
We're gonna bring in Santa Claus. I didn't know he had a motorcycle, but he's got one.
He's got everything. He's
got,
Santa.
Man, he is
whatever
the man.
He wants, Santa gets.
Whatever. Right? Santa sees everything.
That's right. He sees everything.
So we're doing our toy drive and reaching out to our community again, because we can't do nothing without them. To drop off toys for boys and girls. They just from 5 to 14, and we're going to try to have a big Saturday afternoon with a visit with Santa, there at the VFW on the 21st.
Okay, so you can just drop off brand new, in original packaging, unwrapped gifts to the Jessup VFW. They can be dropped off any afternoon at 3 o'clock. VFW sure. Located right behind the Farmer's Market on Project Street.
Yes, sir.
And they may, y'all have other boxes elsewhere else other than the
VFW. Yeah, we're in a process of putting out other boxes.
There's other
as well.
Boxes also.
Yeah.
You'll see the Toy Drive VFW on there.
Yes, sir.
And then on the 21st of December is when you're going to give these out to the kids. Is
yep,
that correct?
Santa Claus.
You have Santa Claus there on coming in on his Harley or whatever, yep. Indian or whatever they drive.
He's coming in sideways with the siren blaring. They might even be chasing him. Who knows? You know how the big guy is, you know. There's no telling.
All right. So a couple of great things the Jessup VFW is doing there. The fundraiser with the golf tournament and then giving back to the kids of this area with the toy drive with putting this together and helping the kids out on the 21st.
Absolutely. And one quick note, we're trying to have our annual Thanksgiving dinner the day after Thanksgiving where we invite the community to come in. More details to follow on that before next week.
Next week.
And we'll drop the information off it. So maybe you guys can pass it out as well.
Okay, so Thanksgiving's on the 28th, on the 29th.
That should
on
be
Friday
on the 29th.
You're yes, going to be sir. Doing what there at the VFW?
Yeah, we're going to be feeding our community and helping out there as well. So it'll be
okay.
We're trying to finish it up, and I apologize for not having the total information now, but it will be coming this week here.
All right. So. Well, Ken, good seeing you again. Anytime you want to come on and help promote the VFW, whatever else you're involved with, because you got a lot of hats. Well, come on in.
Well, you guys have always been awesome. I cannot thank you guys and our community. I love all you guys, and God has blessed us and continuing to bless us. And without you guys and our community, we can't do nothing for our vets and they deserve it. Anything we can give them, they deserve it. And I just want to say God bless our community. I love you guys out there in Radio Land. Butch, Bob, y'all been great to us and every other thing I've been involved with. Y'all just amazing people. And when I say I love you guys. And that means from the heart. So.
Okay. Well, Ken, you take care.
Man, I appreciate you.
We'll wrap up the world-famous Butch and Bob show in a moment.
Delight in a wonderland of holiday magic at Wild Adventures Christmas Wild and Bright. With over 2 million dazzling lights and more to explore, all aglow with holiday sparkle. Enchanting animal friends and captivating thrills add to the festive fun, while the illuminated Carol of the Animals Lake Show highlights South Georgia's biggest Christmas event. It's even bigger, brighter, and wilder than ever before. Select days November 23rd through December 31st. Celebrate Christmas Wild and Bright for only $39.99. Buy tickets at wildadventures.com.
Don't you know, Bob, it's never too cold or too hot on the golf course?
That's not true.
You don't think so?
It's never too hot.
Never too hot, but it could be too cold.
It could be too cold. Sometimes it gets too hot, too.
Yeah, well, when it gets up there in the mid to upper 90s, heat index of 105, that's pretty rough.
But with
cold, you can always put another coat on or something like that. Yeah. Put those warmers on. Got those warmers these days you can put in your shoes. And even Leanne here at the radio station hangs and has one of those warm jackets, that you charge up and then it keeps you warm for a few hours. You can overcome the cold, Bob, by putting on more. The heat, you can only take off so much before people start running you off.
Just not a cold. I said, I moved to the south for the warm weather.
You did not. You moved to the south because your dad got a job.
I understand that. But I stayed in the south.
You stayed in the south. You didn't go back to Pittsburgh, did you?
I was a smart man. I said, I don't need that snow and cold weather. I'll just stay in sunny south.
That's right.
I like the south. I like the warm weather.
You like it warm weather?
Yeah. Okay. I'm a warm weather kind. I don't like it when it gets down to the 20s and 30s. I'm not into it.
Yeah. Well, we'll have 37 tomorrow night and 37 Saturday night. And
fortunately, we don't have that long of it. No,
it's not that bad here in southeast.
But you want to be cold, just start high school baseball season. That's when it gets cold.
That's when really when it gets cold. Waiting for that cold front coming through in mid-February, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, it starts off cold and then ends up hot in baseball season. And then football is exactly the opposite. It starts hot and ends up cold. Speaking of...
both Applin and Pierce are still alive. Applin's at home against Carver Atlanta. Pierce on the road to take on Columbia. Coffee Brunswick is going to be a good game down in 5A, down in... Brunswick, Georgia, and that nice stadium down there, so that it should be a good ball game. So still several teams still alive.
Okay, so you were talking about the University of Buford, which folks were talking about Buford High School. Buford High School. It's not a university; it's a high school.
Look at this stadium; it's a university. go look on. Go on the website.
Go on
the Google
website.
Buford High School and look at their new $61.9 million stadium. They're fixing to build with their jumbotrons, almost as big as Sanford Stadium.
Almost as big as Sanford Stadium.
Right. I mean, with suites.
Suites at a high school football.
Yeah.
61.9 million. That's going to be a good recruiting tool for them, isn't it?
That's why I call them University of Buford.
You know, we had one of our
they're still in the playoffs. You can watch them play Lowndes Friday night on Georgia Public TV.
Lowndes and Buford.
Lowndes at Buford
by night.
Friday night,
tomorrow night.
They won't be in their new stadium. It's not built yet, but it's still pretty nice.
You know, we had a guy on our local position spotlight a few weeks ago, and he was from Camden, and he played football for Camden. He's a big Husky guy.
Yeah.
And he didn't admit being recruited, but you can see that grin on his face when I started talking about it. There's a lot more recruiting going out there in high school sports than I realized. But then if you do that, you've got to set up a permanent address. So it's got to be some sort of relative there for you to be able to do that. I mean, you just can't do that without your parents moving or you having a relative there or something. But it goes on a little more than I think people think.
It's something that a lot of coaches have to deal with. So I say it's tough when other coaches are calling your players trying to get them to come to their school. So, but it occurs more than you would think it does.
Yeah. I didn't really realize that. Not in high school, because you got to have a permanent. That's got to be your address, and it's got to be a reason. You just can't give somebody's address, and because the opposing teams can raise Cain about it, and then every game that you've played in, then that's a loss for them if they say that you're ineligible.
If you can get the GHSA to do anything.
If you can get them to do anything.
Huh? Right. Okay. Good luck with that.
Good. Okay. All right, bye.
Ask Wayne County about that.
All right. Anything else going on, Bob?
My Steelers play tonight.
Your Steelers play tonight? Thursday night football for Steelers? Taking on who?
Cleveland Browns at Cleveland. So
okay.
Need another win. Got my fingers crossed.
They put a Midwestern game teams up there, Pittsburgh and Cleveland. Not that far from each other, are they?
They're close. About an hour drive. So.
Okay.
But hopefully they can get a win.
Well, good luck with those Steelers tonight.
Yeah,
all right, Bob. Have a good evening. Good day. All right, the world-famous Butch and Bob Show here on WIFO 105.5 FM in Jessup, brought to you by O.C. Welch Ford in Hardeeville, also by Murphy Builder Supply, First Southern Bank, and the service department at G&S Auto Sales in Jessup.